This is quite good from an author, Larry Correa. It's called "The 2020 Election Fuckery Is Afoot." I'm more offended by how ham-fisted, clumsy, and audacious the fraud to elect him is than the idea of Joe Biden being president. I think Joe Biden is a corrupt idiot. However, I think America would survive him like we've survived previous idiot administrations. However, what is potentially fatal for America is half the populace believing that their elections are hopelessly rigged and they're eternally fucked. And now, however this shakes out in court, that's exactly what half the country is going to think. People are pissed off, and rightly so. Before I became a novelist, I was an accountant. In auditing, you look for red flags. That's weird bits in the data that suggest something shifty is going on. You flag those weird things so you can delve into them further. One flag doesn't necessarily mean there's fraud. Weird things happen. A few flags mean stupidity or dishonesty, but a giant pile of red flags means that there's bad shit going on and people should be in jail. Except for in politics, where apparently all you have to do is dismiss a bunch of red flags as to be a Democrat and mumble something about fascist voter suppression, then you can do all sorts of blatant crime and get off. I've been trying to keep up with this fire hose of information about what's going on during this clusterfuck on election. Last night I was on Facebook talking about the crazy high third world dictatorship level voter turnouts in the deep blue areas of these swing states was very suspicious. Somebody gaslighted me about how I'd have to do better than that. So this was my quick reply, listing off all of the questionable BS I could think of off the top of my head. The massive turnout alone is a red flag. But as for doing better, the late night spikes that were close enough to close all the Trump leads are a red flag. The statistically impossible breakdown of the ratios of these vote dumps is a red flag. The ratios of these dumps being far better than the percentages in the bluest of blue cities, even though the historical data does not match, red flag. The ratios of these vote dumps favoring Biden more in these few battlegrounds than the ratio for the rest of the country, even the bluest of the blue, red flag. Biden outperforming Obama among these few urban vote dumps, even though Trump picked up points in every demographic group in the rest of the country, red flag. The poll observers being removed, red flag. The counters cheering as GOP observers are removed, red flag. The fact that the Dem observers outnumber the GOP observers 3-1, red flag, and basis of the first lawsuit filed. The electioneering at the polls on video, red flag. The willful violation of the court order requiring the separation of ballots by type, red flag. USPS whistleblower reporting to the inspector general today that they were ordered to backdate ballots to yesterday, red flag. The video of 2 a.m. deliveries of what appear to be boxes of ballots with no chain of custody or other observers right before the late night miracle spikes, red flag. Any of those things would be enough to trigger an audit in the normal world. This many flags and I'd be giggling in anticipation of catching some thieves. And it isn't that I have to do better. I'm just a Gen Pop observer who happens to be a retired auditor with a finely tuned BS detector. This is going to the courts. So now I want to delve into some of these some more. The problem is that there's a ton of info swirling around, some good, some not. It doesn't help that reporters are usually dishonest or not very bright and absolute trash at presenting data. Part of our problem is big tech is actively stomping on stories that make their guy look bad. While compiling these, I discovered that several of the links I'd looked at yesterday had been vanished by Facebook or Twitter. For the last 4 years, half the country was all, Trump is illegitimate, he's not my president, he stole the election, so on and so forth, and that was all based on nebulous ideas about Russian interference. The Russian interference mostly boiled down to them buying ads on Facebook or having fake bots trolling on Twitter last time. This time, the actual giant mega corporations, Facebook, Twitter, and Google, themselves have actively censored stories in order to protect their candidate. So you think that after this pile of suspicious election clusterfucks that makes the game look totally rigged, the other half of the country is going to accept Joe Biden as legitimate? Oh, hell no. When you are auditing, you see mistakes happen all the time. Humans make errors. Except in real life, mistakes usually go in different directions. When all the mistakes go in the same direction and benefit the same parties, they probably aren't mistakes. They're malfeasance. Let's go back a bit to before Election Day to see why people would be suspicious that the game has been rigged. Most of the mainstream polls were utter garbage, off by what I believe to be the largest amounts ever in all of American history. Of course, this thing that surely demoralized the right and helped the left raise funds was just an innocent sampling error rather than a purposeful sampling bias. Then in the weeks leading up to the election, big tech and the media had a concentrated censorship effort to stop what was probably the juiciest October surprise in modern history. But them silencing major newspapers and U.S. senators was just a mistake in their innocent efforts to fact check. Then on election day, states like Florida that were obviously swinging hard for Trump with no possible mathematical way for Biden to come back, the news wouldn't call for Trump. States where it was still clearly up in the air, just based on even the most cursory of statistical analysis, Arizona, they called for Biden ASAP. But that was just innocent mistakes, not an attempt to set the narrative of inevitable Biden victory by major media. When Trump pulled ahead in the Midwestern swing states by what were starting to appear to be insurmountable amounts, they suddenly threw the brakes on the counts. My favorite part of this was when it looked like Trump was going to win, the Chinese yuan crashed, which is pretty telling about how shitty a candidate Joe Biden is. Okay, suddenly stopping all those counts seemed a little weird, but most of America went to bed thinking that this was a close race with Trump in the lead in the Electoral College. Then we woke up in the morning and everybody saw the 538 graph showing a massive middle of the night spike for Joe Biden with almost zilch in corresponding votes for Trump. Now, one of those got walked back as a typo. Again, funny how all these mistakes keep going in one direction. But the damage was already done. And all of a sudden, most of America was paying a whole lot more attention to places like Wisconsin and Michigan than we usually do. That's how flags work. And it turned out that the single six-figure typo was only one of many statistically improbable Biden vote dumps to come. Now, all of my liberal acquaintances were quick to dismiss these with some gaslighting about how it was just deep blue inner cities votes coming in, and obviously they were going to vote for Joe Biden, except that is them deliberately missing the point. It isn't that Biden won those, it's that he won them with statistically improbable amounts. I don't know what the current numbers are now, but of yesterday morning, the Wisconsin midnight mystery dump was something like 98.4% for Joe Biden. That's better than the bluest of blue cities manage. That's better than Biden did in D.C. I saw one 28K dump yesterday. I want to say it was 538 talking about Pennsylvania that was listed as all for Biden. That's basically statistically impossible. In a small populace, you can get 100% of the vote. However, the larger the sample, the more likely there will be dissenting votes. Even in the bluest of blue areas or reddest of red areas, someone is going to be a cranky dissident or an old person is going to fill in the wrong circle. When you get into hundreds of thousands, yet maintain that kind of perfect ratio, basically impossible. Plus, we were supposed to believe that Joe Biden, the guy barely campaigned, who got like 12 sad-looking people to his rallies, was more popular than Hillary Clinton or Barack Obama. This election was just that much more special, except that these few battleground blue cities vote ratios don't match up with other blue cities around America, where it appears Trump's support among every demographic group other than white males went up. Then people were quick to dismiss these statistically improbable spikes with, of course, the male in voting favors Biden. Republicans vote in person, yes, but they don't favor Biden with these kind of ratios anywhere else in America. The ratios are more like 60-40 or 70-30. But 97-3, oh no. So either Biden is a better campaigner to the inner cities, though he rarely left his basement, than the eloquent messianic figure of Barack Obama, or there's simply something fishy going on here. Here's the kicker. The high turnout is the average for the state, but when you drill down on the source of these statistically improbable blue vote dumps, they've got districts with 200% turnout. That's over 200%. There's seven over 100 and a ton of them in the 90s. Now, the quick liberal dismiss explanation for this is that Wisconsin has same-day registration, again, a fraudster's dream, and thousands of people ignored months of TV and social media beating them over the head to get registered to vote and just decided to do it at the last minute because Biden is just that awesome. Trump is just that bad. A whistleblower has come forward from a Michigan post office saying that they were given ballots on November the 4th and ordered to postmark them to Election Day so that they would still be valid. That is so insanely illegal. When the reporter called the postal supervisor who gave the order and asked about it, he immediately hung up. Now, on this one, liberals were quick to dismiss it because it was from Project Veritas, who they hate and say cherry picks their investigative reporting, yet they keep winning all the lawsuits against them. However, the very next video was the response from the U.S. Postal Inspector General, or whatever his title is, I can't remember, about how they were investigating, so this wasn't just some crank going to a reporter. It's been passed up the chain of command. It's an actual whistleblower. A quick note on collusion, because I mentioned it a couple of times now. Collusion is the key to successful fraud. Systems have controls and checks in places, so the best way to circumvent them is to team up with somebody over one of those controls and exploit the gap. That's fraud 101. Which is why, when you go to the post office, your buddy runs to drop off your illegal late emergency save Biden ballots. Or you go to the ward, your buddy the poll worker is running the login book the same day to register all your imaginary friends. Speaking of the imaginary vote, this one is actually hilarious. Democrats are quick to say all votes must count, which apparently includes people who are 118 years old. All those little fraud schemes come in various directions, except the fraud numbers add up quick in a tight race. However, if you are behind by hundreds of thousands of votes in the middle of the night, it requires some audacious level fuckery, which brings us to a red flag you can see from space. The 4 a.m. Biden miracle. This is the third link I've had to pull for this one because Facebook keeps killing the others. Because after the statistically improbable votes came in, they had to toss a bunch of the GOP judges out of the building because of COVID. Remember what I said about collusion? If you've got the actual system with the controls on your side, you can basically do any outlandish BS you feel like, and the only way you're going to get stopped is by an outside power. Hence the multitude of lawsuits we're going to see over the next few days.